to invade, but you and you will leave.
Hi, hi. Is anybody home today?
Nothing for free.
The better question is, who is going to save you from a standard diet going on out there right now? Who is going to actually show up for you if you don't show up for you? How are you going to get different if you don't what? Do different. How are you going to do different when you go out to socialize, when you go out to restaurants, when you are not going to assume the world is going to accommodate you? Because you're the one doing different to get different, right? So what about when you go out to dinner? Make sure you're going somewhere that we have fresh asparagus, we have whatever they have. If they don't even have a salad, you can usually pick and choose. I have several videos called Raw Vegan Goes Out to Eat, and you can type that in and you can see all kinds of tips and tricks. But the point is at the end of the day, you are either going to do one of two things: make it happen or make an excuse. Never assume other people are going to accommodate you. Accommodate yourself, and therefore you role play with yourself. You know what to expect. You arrive with a quiet assurance of, here I am, knowing what you're going to do. You arrive as you, and while you're there, wherever you went, you're you, right? Doing your thing. When you push yourself away from that table, you push yourself away with your integrity and strength and results intact, right? Because you showed up for the promises you made to yourself. You want to get healthy, and this world will take you down if you don't have the right mindset. But today we're not talking about mindset, except this song. Who will save you? You're going to save you. No one's coming. No one's going to magically say, oh, here, Tanny, here's a TannyRaw dressing. No one ever does that. No one even understands what I do in my life, nor do they care. They don't give a rip. You know what I'm saying? But today we're going to talk about a dressing, a quick dressing. This is going to be very few ingredients in there because normally in my dressing, we have something to stretch and bulk it up, making it a large dressing with not a large amount of fat and calories. Why? Because I want to eat all the veggies and I need dressing to go on all of those, right? I like to dunk. Okay, and here's the thing. If you ever want any of my dressings to be a smaller amount because you're not trying to carry in like a mason jar in your backpack and be like, brought my own stuff, y'all want some and it's green and it's like, no. You want to be discreet. You want to not draw attention to yourself, or maybe you do, but maybe you're new at this. So, any of my dressings that you want to make a smaller volume, what happens is they become a more dense situation. You add less of the liquid component, which is typically water, a little less of the stretching component, which is usually celery or the middle of zucchini, something very neutral flavor that I have bulked it up with, right? So you add less of that. Therefore, you have a more dense situation with your flavor. You're gonna have less dressing, but then again, that's very easy to tuck in your pocketbook, which is also known as a purse. Tuck in your pocket if you wanna be a guy that looks happy to see people, you know, whatever you're doing. So anyway, that's the thing you can do. Normally in my dressings, I have a bulk up the dressing situation, like I just told you, almost no calories, like a free food, like celery, for example, but it gives you more volume without more fat and calories. Then I typically have a sweet. Usually in there, I have a little bit of a dried situation, like a date, or raisins of any colors, always organic, sun-dried, okay, non-sulfurized, very important. Maybe we have unsulfurized dried apricots. Maybe I have lacuma powder, which is a fruit that's from Peru that is dried at low temperatures and ground to a powder. You can add a sweetness. One tablespoon equals about the sweetness of one date. But what else is good? It adds the sweetness, but it's a low glycemic sweetener, and it also creates a nice consistency, a stickability to your dressing that's hard to get otherwise. So that's something you can do. I usually look for the organic brand. They have them at Whole Foods, you can get them online, but look for the organic brand, organic raw lacuma powder. You can usually get a pound for about $11, and it lasts a long dang time. So, and it's a matter of, okay, well, you got that instead of the 4 boxes of Debbie cakes this week. What is it that you want, you know? So anyway, my diet doesn't cost me more. I spend less on food than the average person. I mean, unless you're living on ramen noodles. And if you're doing that, I hope you're banking those extra dimes for your hospital bills later, right? So I'm interested in health. Health is my hobby, so I make it happen. But back to the dressing. So typically we have a bulking agent, a sweet, which I just told you. You can even put raw corn in there. You will definitely want to get a non-GMO situation. A lot of people do not do well. Their stomachs do not digest corn well. I mean, it can cause autoimmune flares in some people, not at all. So be mindful of that. I usually have a salty component. Either I've bulked up with celery, which is in itself salty. Also, I could add in kelp flakes, dulse flakes. You could add in some Himalayan sea salt if you want. I do not eat salt and haven't eaten it in 18 years. Probably about 17, but a long time, okay? Also, wakame seaweed, W-A-K-A-M-E, and I love that. It's so salty. Also, these seaweeds, sea veggies, friends, to really regulate your thyroid, get iodine in your body. I had a blood panel done at Hippocrates Health Institute several months ago, back at the end of September, and every level of mine was pristine. I've been doing this a long time, you know, and that felt good. Anyway, so we've got a salting component. We also have an acidic. So either maybe go with lemon or lime. You might could do a, you could do like a blood orange or something like that. Now, if you're a person who has digestive disorders, I would not typically do a juice in there. This it depends on where you are, okay? I don't typically do that. Occasionally I do. If I do that, doing like a little bit of blood orange for my acidic, I'm not gonna put much, maybe 2 tablespoons. And also with my salad, it's gonna be a very simple salad situation, like maybe just green leaf lettuce. Very simple, okay? Easing on my digestion. What else? You could also do apple cider vinegar raw with the mother. The reason why is it's very enzyme-rich loaded, okay? Now, some people will tell you, oh, apple cider vinegar is going to kill you. It's going to pickle your liver. A person with a pickled and diseased liver has really yellow eyes, you know, and the whites. I've been eating that a long time. Now, years ago, when I had autoimmune disease, that was something that could flare that up. So it depends on where you are. And just because maybe you can't tolerate that now doesn't mean you won't be able to tolerate that later. Also, I used to not be able to eat the nightshade family, and now I can. So any of my recipes that have nightshade components, you can switch that out. Say it's got peppers. This one does today. If you can't eat it because of that, then simply switch out the peppers or tomato, something like that, for carrots. Is it going to taste the same? Not exactly, but you're not going to hurt, and it's still going to be good. So there you go. And just realize that you can work your way up to that. You really can heal from disease when you're consistent, okay, and you do all the things. So we have a bulking agent, a sweet, a salty, an acidic, and a fatty. Now, what I always do is I monitor my fats. One day I'll have omega-3 fatty acids in my dressing, my dinner. The next day I have 6, 3, 6, 3, 6. So I run what looks like a 1-to-1 ratio, 3 to 6. But actually it's even more 3 because I'm always getting that mammoth amount of greens, which has omega-3 in there. And also I get a little bit of chia seeds in the day. Not much. I never surpass over 1 tablespoon cumulative of chia seeds in the day. Chia seeds are also not only fat. It's about 66 calories for a tablespoon, but there's all the macros, okay? Fat, carbs, and protein, and it's about 11 calories of fat. Come on, right? That's very low. So don't feel nervous about that. Now, maybe you're a person who can't digest that together right now. So don't do it. Look at where you are and just realize that. Really take an honest look at where you are, and this is the continuum where you are right now, and move forward from there, you know? Okay, so in the fatty situation, I'm either gonna have some soaked nuts and seeds. The reason I soak those is because they become more digestible. The jury's out on this in some people's minds, but this has been true in my life for years. nuts and seeds have enzyme inhibitors in there. So until they're soaked, they're very hard to digest. When I soak them for about 6 or 8 hours, typically I just put them in some pure water overnight. And a lot of times I will soak more than I'm going to eat the next day. Therefore, once I drain them, they will last in the fridge. I put them in a small Debbie Meyer green box after they're soaked and drained, and they will last in there for about a week. I don't know if any further because I always use them by then. I kind of measure out for that. Anyway, so I'm going to have that. I'm going to know how much I'm going to eat. I usually eat about 200 calories from fat each evening, okay? I love raw whole hemp seed hearts. They're a great ratio of omega-3 to omega-6 fatty acids. Raw nut butter, I love the Artisana brand. Always choose one that's no salt and no oil. Look on the back, and some of these friends have, sure, it's got raw almonds, but then what else does it have? It's got salt, it's got oil, it's got palm oil, it's got canola, or what the heck, you know? So really be mindful about what you're doing. Coconut meat is, I have several recipes with coconut meat in there. I don't use that a whole lot because it's harder for me to find here in South Carolina. Avocado, I love that. I showed y'all the other day about the Slimcado, which is great. Those are not GMO, friends. That could come in the works, but as of right now, they're not. You can find them organic, and you can have more amount for the same amount of fat and calories you would get in a small house, so that's something. And if you're trying to stretch that fat out further, this is a good thing to do. Ellie sees a cat outside. Ellie! Also, ground chia seeds and ground flax seeds, a great thing to do, right? Who are you talking to? So we're going to come into the kitchen. This is coming out of my book, Butterfly Dressing. Okay, it's what I was looking at right there. I also have a video called Making Awesome Raw Vegan Dressing Every Time. That could really be helpful for you. So we're going to come to the kitchen. I'm going to plug you in. And because your battery's dying. And look at that. And this won't hurt a bit. You might even like it. Just hold on. Oh, yes. How's that? Okay, so I'll look at your comments in just a second. But what I want to show you, you want to get up? Come here. I don't want to get my hands on her whole place. Come here. You can't see the friends? Or the friends can't see you, huh? If y'all are wondering if I put food on that island because I have a dog on there, I don't. I set my pocketbook, other stuff on there. Anyway, so here's what we're going to do. In our high-speed blender, you can get away with a low-speed blender, a cheapo, and then work your way up. So what we're gonna do, we have our bulking agent. This is about 2 cups of loosely packed celery. Always organic with the celery. Celery is one of those things I never eat conventional. And if it says it's raw on a salad, organic on a salad bar, and it's not, I can tell if those friends are telling me a story because my throat will swell up. The pesticides and herbicides, all these things on the conventional celery cannot be washed off. That's a problem. So anyway, what we have is, and notice I have mostly the lightest parts because it creates less of a pungent tone. You know how sometimes with the celery, it's like super celery tasting, and a lot of people don't like that. And you might be saying, I don't like celery. If you refuse to have this, you could use the same amount in peeled zucchini or yellow squash, okay? So this is going in, right? Now, what we have, this is about 1.5 to 2 cups of red, also organic with the peppers, red bell peppers, okay, going in. Do y'all see that? All right, now what we have, let me get, okay, now this is a raw pecan butter that's on sale right now at, the Fresh Market, okay, it was half price. Anyway, raw pecan butter, all right, a little under 2 tablespoons is 200 calories, and this is 2 tablespoons of freshly squeezed lime. Can y'all see? And I'll show you now. I know I'm gonna get me a little stand to put right here. Okay, then we have some water in here, and this is, let's see how much water we're gonna start with. Because again, remember, this is between 1/3 and 1/2 cup, okay? We're gonna need a little more than that. Let's put, see how much this is. Though, we're gonna put 1/2 cup, okay? And of course, that's just celery in there. Don't get weird, okay? And we'll see how that goes. I'm probably gonna need my tamper. And and I'm going to blend over here and come back to you. Now, if you wanted it to be more dense, you know, like I was saying, and for a smaller container, you could make it really small. You could have a little bit of the celery, maybe, I don't know, a little handful. You could have less of the red bell pepper. See, in this, you're not seeing the sweet, because what I've done is the bell pepper is a flavor component, a punch. It's a sweet and a savory together. Do y'all see what I'm saying? So anyway, you can make a dressing. It could turn out to be this big, or it could be this big. Do you see? A pint or a quart, depending on the amount of bulking situation, in this case celery, or the amount of water you put in there. Y'all liking this? Okay, so also in here we have 2 tablespoons of Dulse flakes, okay, which is the seaweed. Like I was telling you, that's going to add a salty. And then we have 1 tablespoon of this, which is my new favorite seasoning, okay? This is from Frontier Brand Organic Seasoning. These are just dry. They're dried at low temperatures. That doesn't mean they're raw or whatnot. They're dry. People should try not to pee-pee in their pants under stress. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're having a hot tea, I mean, you still are on a raw diet, okay? You can have a hot tea. It's going to be okay. And you can use a little bit of dried seasoning. So anyway, that's just my take on it. These are really good. So tasty. And this goes with so many things. But we're not adding those yet, okay? I'm going to get this blended. And you can be entertained by Ellie while I step right over here. So I'll be right back. Talk amongst yourselves, okay? Hold your ears. This is going to be loud, okay? If you want it to be thicker, you're going to add a little less water. And I could have added a little less, but as this sits here too a little bit, it will dense down. Oh, this smells so good. It smells like a spicy Thousand Island. And what we're going to do is we're going to blend these in on low at the end. You could even put them in your jar and shake them in. Let's do that. So let's go with this jar, okay? Let's put our seasonings in there. The reason I'm doing that is because if you blend up seaweed too much, I mean, this is a beautiful color, right? Well, if you add the dark purple in, it really changes the color if you blend it. But if you just shake it, that's not what's gonna happen, okay? Now, if I wanted more of this, if I wanted it thicker without any more fat, I would add in more celery. If I wanted it to be a smaller dressing, less celery, less water. Y'all know what I'm saying? I'm gonna give it a shake. I'm glad that was closed, because that one again. Okay, should we taste it? Look at that. Can y'all see? Huh? You can't see. Yes, you can. Look at that. This is delicious. Let's see what the texture looks like. Do y'all see? Does that look tasty to y'all? See, it's very beautiful. The thing is too, when you're, my phone don't want to stay charged today. When you're bringing a dressing somewhere, it's really good if it looks kind of normal. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to bring anything that looks like a gray tone or whatnot. Let's have a taste test. Now, what would this be good on? It would be good on anything. It would be good on butternut squash noodles raw. Yes, you can eat those raw. Sometimes people ask me, do I eat sweet potatoes raw? No, those are indigestible to me raw. But butternut squash noodles, yes. Butternut squash soup. I have a really good recipe called Tastes Like Cheese Soup, and it's butternut squash, and it's stretched out. I have so many soups and sauces. You can find those on my search bar. Just type in soup, and they'll come up. Hey, Annie, taste test. Annie, this one's for you. Now, this is what I would like to have this on, is all of these greens. Do y'all see that? And my favorite additive in there, which is fennel bulb. Does anybody like fennel bulb? It has a slight licorice taste. It's got a nice crunch. You slice it really thin. This is another good thing to add in for bulk in your dressing. You don't want to add in the whole 2 cups, but you could probably split like 1 cup. I don't know, zucchini, 1 cup fennel, 1 cup celery, 1 cup fennel. What this is great about this is, even with fennel seed and fennel bulb, is it's great for the digestion. It keeps your body from forming fat pockets in your intestines that makes you gassy and bloated, right? So let's have a taste test, and let's just see, let's check the stickability. Oh, look at that. Now if you want it less thick, it's pretty thick down in the bowl. This is really nice, y'all can't see that good. Shoot. You'll see. Does that look tasty? How does it taste is the question. I love that seasoning blend. Butterfly Reborn, hello. Delicious. Now, if you wanted to, maybe this is another tip. Maybe you want to have some crackers. I have a lot of cracker recipes. I also have the book Butterfly Crackers. There you go. Also, on my YouTube, there's a playlist called Dehydrator Series. It actually says Dehydrated Series, but I don't know how to change it. It's supposed to say Dehydrated Series. Anyway, a lot of cracker recipes there for you. But let's say you do one that all my recipes are stretch the fat. So if they call for flaxseed, let's say it might have 1/4 cup flaxseed with all of these veggies that stretch it out, you see? Anybody can make a good cracker with nothing but just flaxseed. Why? Because there's no moisture in there. It's going to bind to itself. Well, that's great. 1/4 cup of flaxseed is 200 calories, and it's the amount of fat I need in the day. So if I dehydrate that, then I've got this little cube, and it's also like really dense. It's going to be a flax log in my intestines, right? I'm not trying to do that. So I am trying to stretch it out. So let's say we took 1/4 cup of the ground flaxseed. Another tip, unless you grind the flaxseed, you can't digest those. They're just going to pass through you, so you're wasting your time and money, right? I mean, it was tasty, so I guess it wasn't a total waste, but you say, why not uptake the nutrients too? So anyway, you're going to bulk up that recipe. You got 1/4 cup ground flaxseed. You got maybe, I don't know, 4 cups of red bell pepper. Then maybe you have 1 cup of carrots. You're going to blend that all together. You got a little acid going in there. About a tablespoon of lemon juice. Then you got a little bit of salt. You got some wakame seaweed going in there. Bam. So you know that this dehydrator, you got 2 trays out of that, okay? You know that all those crackers have your amount of fat, but you don't really need all those crackers. What you need is some crackers with your salad. Come here. Crackers with your salad. Ellie! Anyway, she heard the door shut. So then you have 1/2 of this dressing, which had your amount of fat in it. So you just had 1/2 your amount of fat, right? And you had 1/2 those crackers. 1/2 plus 1/2 equals the whole amount of fat you need in the night. Okay, so you just stretch that out even further. So what you could do is you could make 1/2 of this could go in your container to take along, maybe to the restaurant, or you're gonna have dressing and salad and crackers tonight and tomorrow night, because Billie Jean has a soccer game and you don't have time to fool with it, right? So here we go, look how beautiful that is. And then you have your other dressing. Isn't this the other 1/2 that you're gonna have tonight? Do y'all see what I'm saying? So there you go, from the kitchen of love and light. Now, I also wanna show you this, which is, sorry, my sauerkraut recipe that I'm going to be coming to y'all. I put a link. I have a no salt sauerkraut video where I did it all with you, but this is a new one, and I have really got the brine going in the beginning with seaweed in this, and it's very delicious. It's salty, and if you're like, well, I don't really like the seaweed, you can't, all you can taste is the salty, delicious, spicy sauerkraut. So there you go. What do y'all think? So let's come in here and we'll see what y'all have to say, and then we'll hop off here because my battery will die. Let's see what y'all are saying. You love the seaweed? Yes, ground flaxseed, really organic, is reminding us that ground flaxseed, you really need to buy those whole raw, okay? And I typically store mine in a Debbie Meyer green box in the refrigerator. The thing is, though, what you want to do is get out the amount that you're going to use then and grind them then, okay? Another thing is, after you use, there is a new product out called VacuCraft, I think it's called. But are these boxes, or you can store your juice in there and then you vacuum seal out the air. So maybe if you are trying to have a low glycemic green juice or celery juice first thing in the morning, but you don't have time to fool with that. You've got 6 cats and 4 kids and a husband who's trying to have a Bible study. Okay. He can't be disturbed. You got to do it all. You're like the Tasmanian devil. You don't have time to juice, but at night you did. So you made that the night before. You used a slow single auger masticating juicer instead of a centrifugal, okay? I have some videos on that, the difference in the types of juicers. The reason why is because a masticating juicer is not gonna heat up the juice. And the juice nutrients, which is what you're after, right? Or you'd have had a Pepsi Cola, right, with peanuts in it. So you're after the nutrients. So you can make that ahead and as long as you get it all the way up to the top, there's no air oxidizing the components in there. You put it in the fridge, it's gonna last for you. And if you use this VacuCraft, bam, I mean, you could be ahead of the game. You could make 2 of those on the evening on Wednesday, then you got it for Thursday and Friday, okay? That's a thing you could do. So just lots of tips and tricks going on in the land of love and light. And I hope y'all enjoyed this. And the main theme of the show is, don't expect this world to accommodate you, because they're not going to, you know? It's just not. You're going to end up failing again and again. How many times have you said, you know what? My lifestyle is a plan of longevity and building more health every day, when it seems like everybody else in my town, at least, is dying. It's sad. And not a quick fix, not a slim fast, not a, well, I'll just starve myself. Well, you know, you're like a person who's 14 years old and you drank too much Mad Dog 2020 and you're laying over the toilet. God, please, I won't do it again. That's how you feel about your food, you know, or do you have a double hangover, alcohol and food? It's time to move forward. Now is the time. If we're waiting on there to be nothing in our inbox, nothing going on, no kids to be doing anything wrong or right, or no celebration, no downfall, no up, no down, no ebb and flow of the tide, no high and low tide. If you are waiting on that, you'll be waiting forever. Now is the time. Now is the time for change. And healing is real. I believe that down deep in my heart. Because I see it time and time again, you know? And it's exciting. When people, I talked to somebody yesterday, and she's really getting past some things in her life. Like, why do I constantly go to this certain type of bread? Why do I constantly go to the alcohol? Why? And she said, what void am I trying to fill? And I thought, exactly. You know what the answer is to that? The answer in releasing addictions? Do nothing. When those urges for toxic food, chemicals, can you be addicted to food? Well, can you be addicted to chemicals? Absolutely. Well, that's what people are eating. And those cravings and addictions are going to surge through your body and through your hand and through your blood, coursing through every cell in your body. And we want something to ease that burden, right? And you can have a hot tea. Maybe you have a little snack. Maybe you're getting all the things. But it's still not Haagen-Dazs, right? It's still not a vodka tonic. It's still not whatever. It's still not sourdough bread. It's still not your addiction. The way to get past that is do nothing. Do nothing. Sit there and let it course through your veins and release it as if you're thinking of that black smoke, like a demon leaving your body. That may sound dramatic, but is it really? Have you been going back to the same thing year after year after year? I used to do that. I grew up living on like a Lucky Charms, whole milk, Chef Boyardee, and Debbie cakes. No wonder I rolled into disease. And you don't have to be diseased. And now's the time. You're never too old, and you're not too young, and you're not too busy. And you are worth it. Because a lot of times, the reason people won't take the time is they don't feel like they're worth it. There's no self-love. You know what I'm saying? You sit there and let that surge through your body. And afterwards, you're like, I didn't give in to that. Or maybe every day after work is the time of day you're going from work to the after school program. You got to go to two different schools. You got to go to karate. You got to do all these things. You still have no groceries in the house. You have nothing to cook for dinner. The laundry, all the stuff. It's insane. I know. And on the way down the road, there's a Starbucks. And you want to stop there. And you stop there every day. And you don't just get a coffee. Your adrenals are burnt out. You can't understand why you have no energy. But if you're going to get a coffee, you might as well get the cream in there. And if you're going to get the cream, you might as well get the syrup. And then you might as well get the La Grande whatever. You know? The large Venti, the whatever. All the chemicals, the sugar, the fat, the caffeine, the crap. And then if you're going to have that, you might as well stop for a candy bar too. If you give a mouse a cookie, he's going to want a glass of milk, right? So instead of pulling in there, you have some tactics. You have some if-then planning. I have a lot of videos on that, if-then planning. And if you'll start to have a plan for yourself, you can have a plan for a new you, and it can actually manifest itself in your world. You're sitting there. If tomorrow at 4:00, I am at that intersection where the Starbucks is. And you're going to be. There's no other way to get through the pass. You live in a two-light town, right? Instead of pulling in there, you have a large water with lemon right there. You have your Craving Crusher tea. You have something to put in your hand. But also, you have your favorite song. You drive a 1986 Astro van, and it still has a cassette tape. And you push that cassette tape in, and you crank down the windows. Right? And you turn up the music, right? And you sing your way right through it. And as you get to another intersection and you've passed that, you're like, that's right. I did different. And now I'm going to get different. What do you think? Mindset strategies, tips and tricks with Tanny. Thanks for coming over to the Cottage of Love and Light. And I love you. And I hope you try those recipes. I hope you come to terms with the fact that ain't a dang person going to come save you. And they don't need to. And that is, first, it will hit you as harsh. And then if you sit there and think about it, it can hit you as empowering. Because nothing do I dislike more than having to wait. Do it self, as my little girl used to say. No, no, mommy. I do it self. You know? And there's no waiting on approval. There's no waiting on nothing now, you know? I love you. Hope you have a beautiful day. You're gonna save you, that's who.